Township is launching an aggressive effort to clean up its properties and its image.
It's going after landowners with maintenance, nuisance, and zoning problems. 9 News reporter Tom McKee found that has set the stage for a legal battle with some longtime residents. Tom?
Well, Carol, that's right. It's said that one person's treasurer might be considered another person's trash. Well, that's the scenario playing out between Colerain Township officials and the Rash family of East Miami River Road. The family has been collecting things for years, but this lawsuit could drastically change all that.
Mert Rash and son Jake are among 6 generations to occupy acreage along East Miami River Road. Home has been Colerain Township since the Civil War.
Morgan's Raiders, when they come through, had my great-great-grandpa shoe their horses down here on Flick Road. He had the farm, first farm on Flick Road.
The land has been farmed for decades. Collections of cars and other items appeared in the 1940s. Much of it can be seen by passersby, and that's what led to this civil lawsuit alleging non-compliance of zoning laws.
It seems like an harassment to me. I don't know, you know. Like I sort of always thought we was grandfathered in for stuff that was here.
Jake Rash says he believes the township is trying to force the family to incorrectly comply with residential zoning codes.
This has been a farm even before zoning regulations were even existent in this part of the country.
We're not targeting any particular part of our community.
Jim Rowan is Colerain Township's administrator and says the Rash property has been a challenge for years.
While I can't speak to the issue specifically because of the litigation, we just want to make Colerain Township a much better place to live, and we're going to do everything we can to enforce our compliance.
Rash has brought in a dumpster from Garden Street Recycling to help haul things away, and he isn't taking new items.
I'm trying to do the best I can and work with him.
He knows if the township wins its suit, the price per day for non-compliance could be $500.
There ain't no way I could ever, ever comply with, you know, paying that kind of money on something like that.
The Rash family vows not to give up without a fight when it goes to court on January 2nd. Colerain Township plans to stand its ground as well. In fact, in tonight's trustees meeting, 5 hearings are scheduled on what to do about condemned properties. Carol?
All right. Thanks, Tom.